did almost the entire unboxing, the Summy Special, and then I looked and I was on mute the whole damn time. So, I'm gonna go at it again. I've already unboxed most of it. There's stuff from Gundam Central, Canadian Gundam, and Hobbyland Japan. So, from Canadian Gundam, which this is not gonna be the last package because I ordered some more stuff they got in stock. They got another big restock. And there are things I never thought I'd get again, and so I did. But anyways, got the high-grade Messer, which is, it doesn't look big here, but if you go like this, ooh, look at that, thick boy. And he is a biggie, I've seen pictures. He's a chunkus. And the figurized Metal Gurumon, because I have the War Greymon, is awesome, and I wanted to get this guy too. Got these cool effect parts on the wings. So definitely gonna enjoy that. And then we got... Sorry, I gotta move some other kits. Alright, we got the NEP 8 armor and the weapons. They should really do this like a picture. So like you put it together and it makes like some kind of diorama. Oh well, lost opportunity. So those are the things from Canadian Gundam. Then from Hobbylink. Actually, I still have some of them in the box here. So, I got these out of the box. This is the SD Gundam Mark IV, which, as far as I know, only model kit ever made is this one right here of the Mark IV. I mean, we now have the RE Mark III, and there'll be a high grade soon-ish, I'm sure. But Mark IV doesn't get any attention. Like, who knows what this guy looks like, and like before now. Oh yeah. And then they also had the SD Camphor, which I like the Camphor. Not a lot of models of it. There's the high grade, the old master grade, and the old no grade. I don't really count the Camphor amazing because it's the same model, just with different armor. I guess you could. But anyways, the other two kits in here. We got the Gundam Aegis Knight, which is like the fact that it combines to make the Re-Rising is awesome, but by itself, this model is really cool. I love it. It can transform. It has a cool weapons. It has king mode. Like, everything about it is really cool. It can become the mobile armor attack mode like the Aegis could do. Yeah, it's a pretty great kit. And then finally, the... can I pronounce you? What are you called? The Hajiraboshi, maybe? It's from, I think, is it a mobile game in Japan? It's like the lead mobile suit from IBO. Yeah, another IBO kit. Man. That's two in like the same year. It's crazy. But there's one more kit, and it is the one from Gundam Center, which you're probably all more interested in. I gotta admit, I'm kind of more interested in too. This is the... Hayate Liger from Supernova. Yeah, another Supernova kit. So, that box is a little beat up from the mail, but it's as long as what's inside, it's okay. I don't care. But yeah, this is, I'm assuming, the same inner frame, but with different armor, which is, I'm sure, what they did, like, officially with the smaller one. But yeah, this thing is going to be fun, because I still have the other one. Actually, right now, it's on top. I don't have a shelf for it, but it's on top of the Dendrobium. But yeah, it's a great kit. So this one should be just as good. And apparently, they're coming out with the third one. It's like that. I can't remember the name of it, but it's a light gray, silvery color. Yeah, that one's coming out soon, too. So, Supernova, going crazy with Wing and Ligers. What a weird combination. But here we are. Anything Supernova makes, I am totally picking up. They need to get into the Armor Girl scene, because I'm sure they'd be doing really great stuff. So anyways, yeah, if you want to pick this up, go to Gundam Central, the other kits, Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.